Hi, my name is Richard Whitt, and I'm a fellow with the Mozilla Foundation. Today, we have what I call three kinds of artificial intelligence platforms. Last time, we talked about the online screens and the environmental scenes in our lives. In both cases, the companies and governments who are creating and employing these, what I call institutional AIs, they want to make us believe that they're operating in our best interests. And as we talked about a bit last time, that's not really the case. The third type of AI is what I call the bureaucratic unseens. And these are those advanced systems that make decisions about us, usually without our input. What jobs we get, what bank loans we receive, what government benefits we're eligible for. There's countless such decisions that are being made every day, happening all the time, and we're not often aware of it. As with these screens and scenes, the AIs behind these unseens represent large companies and government agencies. They're collecting our data, they're analyzing us, they're making all these decisions on our behalf about our welfare. So in the past, human beings, of course, were responsible for making these decisions for us, and we often had some ability to have input into their decisions. Today, though, it's the computer algorithm, often without any direct supervision at all from a human being. They can employ highly biased algorithms and flawed data sets, and all this, again, happening without us having any legitimate recourse. So as we talked about last time, a personal AI is very similar to the artificial intelligence-based virtual engines I described earlier. There's one major difference, however. These personal AIs are programmed to represent us as the individual human beings, so they can protect our privacy, our security, our identity, without promoting conflicts. So just as with the screens and scenes scenarios we talked about, the personal AIs can also be our trusted agents vis-a-vis these bureaucratic unseens by interacting directly with the institutional AIs on our behalf. So one can imagine asking, say, a government agency to give my personal AI specific reasons why they made a decision about me. Maybe there was a job application, maybe there's a benefit for unemployment. Somehow that was denied to me. I should have the right to have my personal AI scrutinize that, to be able to query and perhaps even challenge the analytical and the data-based rationales for these kinds of decisions. So that's on the government side. When you think about the company side, of course, many other kinds of consequential decisions being made that we don't have any involvement in. A good example there is a loan application. So I go to my local bank, I want to get a small loan for my business, I'm turned down. I'm not sure why, the bank doesn't tell me. There are requirements for individual human beings to give me some rationale, but again, these AIs often operate without any direct supervision from human beings. And so having the ability for my personal AI to look at the same evidence, to look at the same data, the analytics that are utilized there, and then be able to query, challenge, if necessary, where there's some flaws in that process. So the steps required to get to this scenario vis-a-vis the ones we've talked about earlier are very similar as with the screens and scenes. We need to have the technology, which, as I mentioned, is largely already there. The marketplaces will be developing. We need the standards, which are the common protocols, so that these different systems can connect and talk to each other. And we need the laws to align, so that governments and companies can accommodate these new kinds of citizen tools. And I do believe that's that last point. The laws, the policies are what we need to change in order to give us the ability to use personal AIs in all three of these situations. In particular, the right to delegate and the right to query, so that my personal AI can act on my behalf and is able to then question and challenge decisions coming out of the institutional AI systems.